In this video, we'll look at how you can show and hide objects in Maya. Let's start with deciding on what's displayed in a scene using the options in the Display Show menu. These options affect what can be displayed in all viewports and what's rendered, similar to the options in the Display menu in Softimage. You can display basic objects like different types of geometry, lights, and cameras, as well as more specific types of objects such as fluids, hair, follicles, cloth, particles, and rigid bodies. The show commands are not toggles, so if you want to hide a certain object type, you need to choose the command of the same name in the Display Hide menu. There's no indication in the menus as to which object types are hidden, but in the outliner, the names of hidden objects are in gray. Note that when you choose the Hide Lights command, it hides the light icons, but it also removes the effect of the lights if you have the Use All Lights option on in the viewport. For more information on the Show and Hide filters, see the video Setting an Object's Visibility in Maya on this channel. When you show or hide objects from these menus, it sets the visibility attribute for all objects of that type. For example, if you hide polygons, you can see that this object's visibility attribute is off, but you could actually override this and turn it back on. This is different from Softimage, where hiding an object type does not affect an object's visibility options in its visibility property page. To set the visibility for a hierarchy of objects, select the parent object and toggle the visibility on its Transform tab. To set the visibility for only the parent object, but not its children, go to the parent's Shape tab, or press the down arrow key, and toggle the visibility there. Once you have the options in the Display menu set up for all viewports, you can toggle items in each individual viewport's Show menu. Note that the Display Hide commands override what you can display from the Show menu. For example, you can't display lights in the viewport if you select them in the Show menu, but they're hidden in the Display Hide menu. The Show menu is similar to the Eye icon menu in the Softimage viewports. You can press Ctrl to keep this type of menu open while you select multiple options. As in Softimage, showing and hiding objects in the individual viewports doesn't affect what's actually rendered. It's just for the display in that viewport. To show or hide objects for a Play Blast or a flipbook, you have the same Show menu options when you select Show, Play Blast, Display. So that's how to choose which type of objects you want to have displayed in your scene. But what about just hiding objects in general? The quickest way is to select one or more objects and choose Display Hide Hide Selection or press Ctrl plus H. This turns off that object's visibility attribute, the same as with the object's visibility options in Softimage. You can also do the inverse with the Hide Unselected Objects command, and choose Hide All to hide every object in the scene, whether it's selected or not. To redisplay all hidden objects, choose Display Show Show All. The main way to redisplay hidden objects is to select them in the outliner and choose Show Selection or press Shift plus H. You can also choose Show Last Hidden to redisplay the most recently hidden objects. As you're working in your scene, you may want to focus on certain objects or components. To do this, you can select an object or its components and choose Show, Isolate Select, View Selected, or click its icon in the panel toolbar. This is similar to the Isolate Selection command in Softimage. To do the opposite and hide components in Softimage is easy. Select the components and press H. If you want to do this in Maya, there are a few more steps and the results are a little different. Select the faces you want to hide, press Ctrl plus Shift plus I to invert the selection, and then choose Isolate Select. This hides the components, but also hides the rest of the scene except for the object that owns the components. You could also use the Toggle Selected Faces Display tool that is available as a bonus tool. Simply select the faces you want to hide and choose this command. You'll notice that the rest of the scene remains visible. You can then select more faces and click the Show Hide button. Click this button again to display everything you've hidden and exit the tool. To download the bonus tools, choose Help Resources and Tools, Download Bonus Tools. This brings you to a page on the area where you can click a link to the Maya Exchange Apps page. Select your operating system and click the Free button to download the tools. The next time you open Maya, a bonus tools menu appears with all of them available. When you have a more complicated scene, the best way to go for controlling object visibility is to put objects in display layers, as you do with scene layers in Softimage. You can toggle the visibility of objects in a layer by clicking the first cell so that a V appears. In the second cell, you can click until a T appears to show a templated or ghost image of the objects in this layer. Templated objects are wireframes just used for visual reference. You can't select or snap to these objects. If you click this cell until an R appears, the objects become referenced. Although referenced objects look like normal objects, you can't select them, but you can snap to them. So if an object looks normal but you can't seem to select it, check to see if it's in a layer that's referenced. To help you quickly display, select, and hide objects that are in layers, check out the Layer Viewer that is available as a bonus tool. You can watch Stephen Rozelle's YouTube video, Maya Bonus Tools Layer Viewer, to see how to use it. If the objects aren't in layers, you can still set a temporary override on whether the objects are normal, templates, or references. In the Attribute Editor, open the Display section to the Drawing Overrides attributes and toggle the display type. You can also change the appearance and visibility with different display options, and also change the wireframe display color for the object. We made these changes on the Objects Transform tab, so it affects all children of that object. Again, if you want to affect only the parent but not its children, you can set the drawing overrides on the Parent's Shape tab. In the next video, we'll explore how objects look in the viewport with display modes and decide which viewport elements to display.